Ronnie Cameron has been jetting around the country for the past 2 months, interviewing with National Football League general managers from coast to coast, hoping one of them makes him the first Old Dominion University player taken in the NFL draft. In all, he has been on 18 flights since his senior season ended.
I went to the movies the other day and I'm looking for a seatbelt because the only seats I'm used to getting into are, you know, airplane seats. So it's been a hell of a ride though. It's been a great ride.
Cameron has met with general managers from the Super Bowl champion New York Giants, the Crosstown Jets, the San Diego Chargers, Houston Texans, Arizona Cardinals, Jacksonville Jaguars, and the Kansas City Chiefs. They have measured him and worked him out, but they have also quizzed him and asked him to take personality tests.
And think about it, when you go on these visits, you talk more about life than you do about football. They want to see who you are as a person outside of football. Because you know they're not paying you just to be a football player. You're being a part of the organization as a person.
Between trips, Cameron has done his best to prepare for his soon-to-be professional football career, and visits ODU's weight training facility as often as possible. The 6'2", 300-pound defensive tackle intends to arrive in training camp in the best shape of his life.
I've actually leaned out a lot, and you know, and just worked on speed and flexibility and things like that. I feel like I'm way better. I feel like I'm a lot better of an athlete now than I was at the end of the season.
There are only 7 rounds, and if he isn't drafted, the common belief among analysts is that the Colonial Athletic Association Defensive Player of the Year will sign with somebody as a preferred free agent.
And then it becomes your decision. Then it becomes like a recruiting process where everything's offering you a certain amount of money in terms of a signing bonus, and then you have to choose what team that you felt you could best fit in with, you know, best location for you personally, and just the best opportunity you can make a team. So that's pretty much how free agency works.
Of the teams Cameron visited, the Jaguars have the most notable reputation for taking small college players in the draft. They have gone outside the Football Bowl subdivision to make 9 of their 20 selections in the last 3 years.
It's definitely a big factor because you know, they're proven. They're proven to take guys who aren't necessarily from the big schools like the Oklahoma and the Texas and the SEC schools. And they take them and they have good coaches that are used to players like that.
After playing in 2 All-Star games and having all 32 NFL franchises take a look at him somewhere and at some time during the last 4 months, it now comes down to the 3 days of the NFL draft, which begins Thursday. With Cameron predicted to go somewhere between the 5th and 7th rounds, Saturday will likely be the day he hears his name called and his phone ring.
I'm a little tired because, you know, I've been traveling a lot. But definitely excited. It was more anxiety a few weeks back, but now it's more excitement because I've been, you know, different places. I've spoken to a lot of different coaches. So now I'm excited about, you know, the prospects of where I might be going.
For the Virginian-Pilot, I'm Rich Radford.